You forget the whole history. Probably has dementia. You forget all of it was happened beforehand. And the Torah says he start to make hardship of the Jewish people. Now, in the Torah by itself, it says Yosef died, all his brothers, and the old generation. And then, from that time, start their shibud. It's called the shibud.
The destruction.
What's called a shibud?
Slavery.
Slavery. Destruction. But if you look at the first Rashi in Parshas Vayechi, it says, Vayechi Yaakov Beretz Mitzrayim. Says Rashi there, Lama Parsha Zu Setuma. Why this Parsha Vayechi doesn't have, between Vayigash and Vayechi, is no
opening.
Together. Says the Gemara, Lefi, what Yaakov Avinu was Nifter, right? He died. His Chilu Tzoras HaShibud. The Shibud start. What then Nistemu Einayim VeLibam Shel Yisrael was blocked. The eyes in the heart of the Jewish people. Is the first Rashi yet? Do you have it?
I do. Kamok Yinei V'Kamok.
No. No Kamok.
I got it.
Here, Vayechi. Oh, that's your stuff.
You have it, Rabbi?
No, I have.
Forget his name. What's his name?
Shlomo.
Reb Shlomo. Reb Shlomo. Here's the first Rashi here in this part, in Parash Vayechi. Rashi says,
so you say, did you see a little blue machine here?
In Rashi says here,
no.
Vayichi Yaakov, lama parsha stuma. Lefi shekevon shenifta Yaakovinu, Yaakovinu was nifta. Nistemu einayim v'nifta shel Yisrael from what? Mitzoras?
Shibud.
It's a contradiction. Here it says the Shibud start when Yaakov Avinu died, right? This is here, right? And in Parshas Shmos, it says the Shibud start when Yosef died, and all his brothers, right? And the old generation died, and then the Shibud start.
That's right.
You hear Reb Shlomo, the question?
Yeah.
No, Rabbi, so you have an answer on it?
No. No answer.
No answer on it? I quit. If you have the answer on it, I quit. No, Rabbi, so what's the answer? The answer is what really the destruction that's called the slavery was in two fashions, spiritually and physically. Before the Yidden went down to Mitzrayim, Yaakov Avinu says, you know, you can't go out down Mitzrayim before you're making. I send Yehuda, and what to do for Yehuda? What to do? No, who knows?
Yeshiva.
A yeshiva. Yaakov says, I can't go there without a yeshiva. This was already beforehand. Number one, a yeshiva. Number one, a yeshiva. Because, you know, some people, they're buying a house, and now they're buying a house. That's the word, the shul, 8 miles from here. Right? So Yaakov says, no, I want to know what the, before I'm going there, where the shul is, where the yeshiva is. Beforehand. And therefore he sent Yehuda to make a yeshiva there. When Yaakov Avinu was lifter, his Paro decided, let's close down the yeshiva.
Oh.
Because Yaakov Avinu was the older one. He was Rosh Yeshiva. Mm-hmm. Head of the yeshiva. This was a first destruction in the serf slavery. No spiritual, the slavery. Then there was a second slavery. This was the what?
Physical.
This start in Parashat Shemot. When Yosef died, all their brothers in the old generation, and then Vayemoreru Eschayeyem, they made bitter their life. But really, and this will lead many, many things in Chumash Shmos, what was two type of slavery, one physically and one spiritually. Torah says, came in a new king on Egypt. We didn't know Yosef, mm-hmm. right?
Mm-hmm.
If, ask a question, just a halacha question, nothing is. If you renew your house, you know, every few years, you have to tell you, hey, we have to change. Have to change. To change. New floors, new walls, right?
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
For every new thing, what bracha you make, if you buy a new thing, what bracha you make?
Shechiyanu.
Oh. Yeah? Right?
Yeah.
If you renew your house, you have to make Shechiyanu? Renew your house. You made new windows, new floor,
Renovate. Oh, yeah.
New walls, right?
Yeah.
You spent over $100,000. You make your wife happy. No this.
Now that deserves a shech, yeah.
What?
if you make your
for wife happy. For this year, it's also true. It's also true. It depends what we're learning here.
Okay.
Vayakam Melech Chadash, right? A new king.
Yeah.
What was the new king here? What was new? Is a real new king?
Right, not necessarily.
No, it's not to say. Open yourself, yeah?
Right, not necessarily.
Is a machloikis Rashi brings down, right?
Yeah.
Two opinions. One was real new.
Yeah.
And one wasn't the new, it just refurnished the rules and made new rules. Until now, the Jews was democracy,
yeah.
And now he made a change, right?
Mm-hmm.
And the Torah calls the king, what he called him? New king. And this depends. He was saying the new king is really a new king. As you refurnish your house, you don't make Shechiyanu. Because it has to be real new. But if you're saying, is the new king, what he did? What he did with the rules? What he did in the new king? What he did?
Change the rules.
Change the rules, but he wasn't really new, right? And still the Torah call him what?
New king.
New king. It's mean can be old king, right? It just redesigned the house. It's called new. Is the word chadash is not always its mean new. Can be old one. It's called the right?
Yeah.
Sometimes, second time when the president was voted into his chair, you call it the new president.
Mm-hmm.
Is it a new? No, it was there 4 years before, right? Why call it new? Because the word Niyu has always two meanings. When Moshe Rabbeinu was born, and right, is you remember who gave him the name Moshe?
Batya.
Batya, not his father and mother didn't give him the name Moshe.
His name was Tuvia.
Name was Tuvia, maybe. She gave him the name Moshe. We speak later why it was given the name Moshe. But you remember the story is what Melech Mitzrayim called for the Jewish ladies. And he told them, you know, you have to do this and that. You know, it wasn't so simple, it wasn't so easy. And the Torah says, one of the daughters, Mibeis Levi, went, she got pregnant, and she a baby, and she can't hide them anymore, right? And she took him and put him in a basket inside. Yeah, remember?
Yep.
The basket. And she took the baby inside between the
reeds.
The reeds there. And the daughter of Paroi, what was his name?
Batya.
She heard a Jewish boy, what he was doing?
Crying,
a special cry, a Jewish cry, a special cry. She heard him crying. And it says, in words, Vatishlach es amosa. She stretched out what?
Her hand,
and she took him. How far was Moshe from the shore?
50 feet.
Then what means to stretch out a hand? You can stretch out your hand 50 feet?
No, not today.
Not today. When younger, you can do it?
Of course. I could do anything.
You can do anything. You can do it? What? You're saying what?
Hashem made a miracle.
What was the miracle?
So that, she was able to reach him.
Yeah.
How? How made the miracle?
Stretch the arm by 50 feet.
You know what?
What?
I will tell you. Ask a question. Really, if there is $10,000, right?
Yeah.
And you want $10,000, you would stretch your hand for $10,000? Yeah. Would we have from here to there?
Yeah. Right.
No.
Right.
It's impossible, right?
Right.
What was Batya's idea when she stretched out her hand? He was far away, 50 feet.
Yeah.
And she stretched out her hand.
Yeah.
The hand was normally at. What was her idea? Well, miracle? What was her idea to stretch out the hand?
She was going against the law.
Was against the law?
The law was that she knew that there were Jewish boys in the river being thrown to die. And so she went against her father.
It's true. But why she stretch her hand? What the stretch hand has to do with that? Stretch hand can go, 1 foot, right? Maybe,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
2 feet. She knew before, and I stretched my hand. The $10,000 is there. The idea is, if somebody doing his maximum what he can do, right? The rest is the Ribbono Shel Olam is doing. She did her maximum. And the maximum was what she can do in such a case? Stretch out the hand. Somebody would say, I'm not starting even. I know it's not working. She says, no. I will do my maximum. And the rest, the Ribbono Shel Olam will do. It's a very interesting story. In the Second World War, was a yeshiva in England. The Rosh Yeshiva was Rabbi Moshe Schneider. Famous Rosh Yeshiva, Rabbi Schneider. The yeshiva suffered a lot in that time. Wasn't food to eat, was the middle of the war. And if it was food to eat, didn't have money to pay for their food.
Yeah.
And it was also a trouble if there's no food. The boys from yeshiva wasn't encouraged to learn. Is a war in the world. It was terrible time. No encouragement to learn and no food. He didn't know what to do. Was two boys in the yeshiva. The boy's name was Moshe. All he called them in are these boys to the initiative. And they says, no food. One Moshe says, I will try to go around to find food. It wasn't any seichel, because the Rosh Yeshiva owned money in every bakery and every store. Another one says, you know what? I will go and I will try every morning to take out the boys from the bed. It wasn't logic what the boys will get out. He says, you know what? I will do the maximum. I will go every morning. Hey, get up. Hey, get up. Hey, get up. One Moshe took on his shoulder a sack. And he went out from house to house, from store to store, from bakery to bakery, until the afternoon he had a full sack with food. Another one got up in the morning and used to go from bed to bed and plead the Bachrim, get up. There's no many people learning Torah now. It's a war. The world may be standing on you. Get up and let's go to learn. He was successful. You know who was two Moishes? Know who was this? The one who went with the food with the sack was Moshe Reichman from Toronto. You know him?
Oh, I know him. He's from Toronto.
Moshe Reichman from Toronto. He became a very, very rich man. The another one who wake up the Bochum every morning is now the nearly the chief rabbi in Jerusalem. His name is Moshe Sternbuch. Rabbi Moshe Sternbuch. It's mean. If you do things what people says, hey, why you start with this? But you say, I don't care. I will do the right thing, which is right now. If it's good or not good, we'll see it later. We'll see it later. And they did it. It was two Moishes. Moshe Reichman and Moshe Sternbuch. This is also Moshe Rabbeinu here. She, Batya, stretched out the hand till the end. Do as much as possible. Even doesn't make sense. I says, I will try how much as possible I can do. She, The Ribbono Shel Olam made the rest, made the hand longer. But she did the maximum was possible. You know, this is in life also.
Wow, good story.
Requesting the Ribbono Shel Olam from us is always to do the maximum we can do. We're not angels. The way it is. But we can do sometimes a little bit more. A little bit more. The maximum. If we will do the maximum, the Ribbono Shel Olam will do his maximum. When we're doing our maximum, he's doing his maximum. It says, you like the story?
Yeah.
It's a true story. It's not made up today. It's a true story. It says in Torah HaKadoshim, in the beginning, Ve'ele Shemois B'nei Yisrael Haboim Mitzrayimo, they came to Egyptian, Es Yaakov Ish U'Beisoi Bo, right? If you look at right, the pasuk, tell me what is the last letter be'es? Last letter? Tough. Yaakov, what's the last letter?
Base.
Base.
Ish, what's the last letter?
Shin.
Shin. If you put together in backwards, what letter, what word comes out? Shin base letter. What is?
Shabbat.
Shabbos. Shabbos. Good?
Yeah.
And then, let's go another thing was going on here. B'nai, what's B'nai, last letter? Yud.
Yud.
Yisrael? Lamed. Haboim? Mitzrayimah, the last letter?
Hey.
Puts together, is Hey, Mem, Lamed, and Yud.
Mila.
Mila.
Mila. Balaturim says in this pasuk is made the Torah remains the mitzvah from Bris Mila in the mitzvah from Shabbos.
Oh. Wow.
Why the pasuk brings down in the beginning with the coming down to Mitzrayim the mitzvah from Shabbos in the mitzvah from Bris Mila? What has to do with the coming down, the 70 souls to Mitzrayim, the mitzvah in Shabbos, in the mitzvah of Bris Mila? It says, from the Ari HaKadosh. What all generations, it's a different angle as there the nations which is around us, doesn't matter, this was in the last 1800 years, as all always, when they went against the Jewish people, they try always. What to do? Number one, don't keep Shabbos, the Jewish people.
Mm-hmm.
Don't keep Shabbos. Number two, don't do the mitzvah of Bris Mila.
Oh.
Do it. Even it works again the right logic. Because if the Jewish people close down their business Shabbos,
yeah,
then the goyim have more business.
Oh, yeah.
If your business closed down, they go to another store. No, you should be open also your store.
Mm-hmm.
Why, you idiot? If I close down the store, the people go to another place to buy.
Yeah.
The mitzvah of Bris Mila is really pouring blood from the Jews. What's it disturb you? They pouring blood in their blood. They become weaker. Mm. They pouring out their blood. But there's no logic here. It wasn't a logic fight. So it was just, yeah, to go against the our belief.
Mm-hmm.
Our, the always the people should understand. You have something what's called the Jewish people, the difference between the Jew and the Gentile, the all is a three points. What's called Mokoim,
place.
Zman,
time.
Nefesh,
soul.
Soul. Mokoim is called place. Zman is called time. Nefesh is called soul. This is what it says. Maybe Rabbi Lel will understand it. It says from Ari HaKadosh, what it says, something, Olam, Shana, in Nefesh. Olam is a world.
Place.
Shana is calendar.
Yeah.
And Nefesh is soul.
Yeah.
This is three things what generally the Jewish believe. Basic is different from the Goyish world. What's called Makoim is a place. What's Shana, a Makoim, Zman is time. Nefesh is the soul. Yom Kippur is the holiest time, right? You know why? Because Yom Kippur, the Kohen Gadol going in the place, what Makom, the holiest place,
right,
is Makom. When he is going, Yom Kippur is the holiest time. Is time, and who is going? The Kohen Gadol, which is the holiest soul. Is in one time is become these three things together, the place, the time, and the soul. It's clear? Everyone understand? Should repeat again. Rabbi Yamin, his name Rabbi Yamin. No, you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, repeat it again.
I repeat again. Place, time, and soul.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yom Kippur. When the Kohen Gadol came inside to work in Beis HaMikdash, Yom Kippur was the man, the holiest man, in the holiest time, in the holiest place.
Yeah.
It's come together the three holiness. We're saying Kadosh, no?
Kadosh,
Kadosh, Kadosh.
Oh, wow.
Kadosh.
Wow.
This is time, soul, and place. Come together. And this is these three things is prevent for the Jewish people not to assimilate in their area. Because if a Jewish person keeps Shabbos, right, then it's different because his neighbor is keeping all Friday or Sunday.
Right.
Right? If the Jewish person has Bris Milah, physically is it different between him and his neighbors.
Right.
And if a Jewish people going to a place, to a shul, to a yeshiva, is a different place. Is a makom. Yaakov Avinu, before the Jewish people went down to Mitzrayim, he was looking very much, we need to go. Is a hunger, and be able to take care about our families. Mm-hmm. But I don't want my children should mixed in. In what?
With them.
With them. Assimilate with them. Right. I must do three things. I must do a place. Mm-hmm. I must do a time. Mm-hmm. And I must do a soul.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Is the place, we said beforehand, Yaakov sent Yehuda. To where?
Goshen.
To Goshen. For what?
Set up a yeshiva.
Set up a yeshiva. I need to have a place. A makom. A makom, a place. I need to have a time. Different way they have time. What was the time? No, what was the time?
Shabbos.
Shabbos.
Right.
Shabbos. This was the beginning. It says Shabbos.
Right.
Need to make my children different soul from their neighbors. What was the different? No? Bris
Milah.
Bris Milah. It came together before they went down to Mitzrayim. Before Yaakov want a prevention. A prevention between my children and the nation around. And the prevention was Mokoim. Time. Zman is Mokoim place. Zman is Shabbos. So time. In Nefesh is the soul. Soul. And this is actually the connection between this parasha and Chanukah. Because what was Chanukah the Greeks would like to do? To take away from the Jewish people, what would it take away?
Milah, Shabbos.
Milah, Shabbos. No, in what more? And Rosh. Rosh Chodesh.
Rosh Chodesh.
Milah is the soul, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah?
Uh-huh.
Shabbos is the time, mm-hmm. right? In Rosh Chodesh is a place, because where they used to make Rosh Chodesh every month?
Sanhedrin in Jerusalem.
And Sanhedrin in Yerushalayim, the guy would saw the moon from far away, right? He has to come up to where?
Yerushalayim.
El ha-mokoyim hazeh, to this place. He has to come to this special place, which is Yerushalayim. He has to come there because there is the place. Right? This is the mokoyim, place, zman, time, in nefesh. Is therefore Yaakov Avinu fears prevention. No prevention medicine? Right? You go to a doctor before you got sick. Right? The same Yaakov Avinu before they went down to Mitzrayim. So they're going down. Yaakov Avinu says, let's make a mokoyim, besamedresh, make a time, Shabbos, and make a nefesh soul, bris milah, then it can be a prevention between my children and the Egyptian. Look at the first pasuk. Ve'eile shmois b'nei Yisrael. No, read the pasuk. Come on, you say.
Ve'eile shmois.
Rab Shloime, you read la, you have al-koyre. No, ve'eile shmois. Habaim Mitzrayim. Habaim. Nu Es Yaakov. What is the difference between Habaim and Bo?
Future tense.
Oh, very good, very good. One is Habaim. They're coming now. This is the names of the Jewish people, Abayim, they coming now. Et Yaakov Ishu Beito Bau, they?
Atid.
No. Bau, they came already.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah? Yes. Habaim is the coming now. Bau, they came already. They came already. In Galus, in exile, you have two type people. You have people who are they coming now, like Torah says, Habaim, and you have people who are they Bau. What's Bau?
They came.
They came already. Going back in our country, in going back in the early 1900s, in the 20s, in the 30s, what really was very hard to keep Torah and mitzvahs in this country. It was very hard. Very hard to keep Shabbos. Very hard Jewish education. But you have some families where they really was very, very strong. They didn't give up.
Yeah.
You have many families also where they gave up. Even the newcomers came, used to tell them, listen, you want to keep here, willing to be here, live here long life, long, many years. We know exactly it's where you can't do it. Mm-hmm. You have families that says, you don't look at the people or they here a long time. You look like you're coming today. Every day, you are coming today. And don't give away your tradition. When you're coming down from the boat, right? Don't give it away. Stay in the same way like you came here. Yeah?
Yeah.
It's two ways to look at the exile. One, look at the exile, I'm here a long time. What can I do? So, long time. You have some people say, no, I don't care a long time. I'm today, I come today. Today is my first day.
Okay.
Today I arrive with the boat. Even I've had 20 years. Is that every day is for me like today I came here.
Okay.
The difference is the people used to say, hey, I'm a long time here. They lost the tradition. But the people would you say, I come today. I'm here today. Even I'm 20 years now. I came today.
Okay.
Look now in the pasuk. Ve'eile shemois b'nei Yisrael. This is the name of the people of b'nei Yisrael. Haboyim Mitzrayim. They're coming today. Every every day is today. But he had between them as Yaakov Ishu Beisoy bow. They came already many years beforehand. This is one way to understand. But there's another meaning to understand. Yaakov Avinu, before he went down with the family, what really he did beforehand? He did a yeshiva. They didn't came with empty teeth there. It means they already was there before, few years beforehand. They made the roots. They have there. What was the roots?
Torah.
A yeshiva. Is Eile Shemos Bnei Yisrael Haboim Mitzrayimo. They came already before and to Mitzrayim. With what? When Yaakov Avinu sent to make a yeshiva, they was already there. The embassy for the Jewish people was the yeshiva before the Jewish people came. And then Es Yaakov Ish Ibeisei Bo is called like you came beforehand, but Haboim, like you're coming now. It's two ways how to live in exile. I'm long in exile, or my day is today is a first day. When the people are saying, I'm a long time here, it can be. No. Today is my first day. And every day is a new day. I will look at my life in a different way. Kol tov.
Oh,
wow, thank you. Beautiful. Thank you.